There are 20 active cases of coronavirus in Victoria. That's one additional case, a locally acquired case, that was notified to the department in the last 24 hours. We'll go into the details of that, such as they are, soon. 20,116 test results received today. That's a strong number. I want to thank every single Victorian who went and got tested. It is the most important thing. Any symptoms whatsoever, get tested and do it as fast as you can. We'll get your results to you in 24 hours, and you will have played such an important part in keeping us safe and ensuring that this is a short circuit breaker event that can bring a sense of confidence and control to our coronavirus circumstances. That means we've done 4,672,661 tests since the beginning of the pandemic. Now, in terms of the Holiday Inn, that now means we have 14 cases that are linked to that particular premises. The additional case is a social primary close contact, a friend of one of the Holiday Inn workers. Overnight and within 8 hours of that test coming to us, all 38 household primary social close contacts of that person have been contacted, have been locked down, and we are have already begun the process of testing each of those 38 people. That'll be a big focus of our efforts today. And we hope to be able to report negative results, and all results, I should say, as soon as they come to us. That's most likely a feature of tomorrow's briefing. That will be a very big focus today, to get all those people tested, get them through the labs, and hopefully rule those people out. In terms of the Holiday Inn more broadly, as of last night, we've identified 996 known primary close contacts that are related to that particular facility. And the people who work in it. As you know, that number will keep on growing because as we find more and more people come forward, QR codes, all the interviews, contact tracing. So that's not a bad thing. That's in fact exactly what we want, the strategy working, finding more and more people and then putting a public health response around them. We will be able to I think Jerome will be able to take you through how many we've had test results from and how many we expect to start to come through in the next couple of days. Today's not the big day for those results. The balance of those will start to come through tomorrow, Monday. That's why we chose Wednesday as the important day, a five-day circuit breaker, not three or any other shorter period of time. In relation to Brunetti's, I'm very pleased to be able to say that 11 of the 12 Brunetti staff have been tested and they have all come back negative. That is very significant, given that they were at the highest risk of exposure, given their proximity to the infected co-worker. Doesn't mean that all the challenges in association with that business, their customers and the Terminal 4 issues are over, far from it, but that's very positive news. You'd obviously always prefer to be getting negative results than positive results. Just before I ask Jerome to add to my comments with a bit more detail, a bit more specificity about some of the work that has been going on and continues 24/7. Just a couple of points. Firstly, the Prime Minister has agreed to suspend flights, as I had asked, during this five-day period. That takes a little bit of time. It's not an instantaneous thing because, of course, flights are already in the air and people are already well and truly on their way to coming home. They may be in transit. They may have stopped in Singapore, for instance, or another place. To get a connecting flight, all of those issues. So there'll be five more flights arrive between now and the end midnight, and we think there's about 100 passengers on those. They'll be appropriately taken care of, but there's no further flights beyond those five until at the earliest next Thursday, but we'll keep you informed of that as we get closer to Thursday. Just in terms of the broader issue of hotel quarantine, I've asked our experts to look at a risk assessment in terms of these issues in light of this rapidly infectious, fast-moving and very, very infectious UK strain. I don't have, obviously, the outcomes of that thinking, but when I do, I'll certainly have more to say. And that'll be Victoria's position in hopefully a national discussion about the real risks that this UK strain poses to us, both now and until we get that vaccine rolled out. Just finally, I know that a lot of people will be hurting today. This is not the position that Victorians wanted to be in, But I can't have a situation where in 2 weeks' time we look back and we wish we had taken these decisions now. I've got advice to do it. I've done it. It's based on science. I know there's a lot of pain out there, and I will have more to say about support for business and support for others who have been negatively impacted by this absolutely necessary public health measure to protect all the things that we've built, this precious thing that we've built. Victorians know what has to be done. We've done it before. We've shown a courage and a character and a compassion for each other that sets us apart. That's exactly what's happening today. But I know it's not easy, and that's why there'll be support there, and I'll have more to say about that at the appropriate time.